Imagine you're stranded in an island. By whatever means, we don't know. What's crucial is that you're by yourself. Your common sense tells you that, aside from help, of course, you need food and water. You look around and see fruits. There's also a lot of water out there. You think you could do just fine. There's only one problem, though. The water is salinated. If only there's something you could use to get potable water. And quick! Gladly, there is. Meet the graphene oxide saltwater sieve, which could desalinize water. So, how does it work? Desalinization is not a new concept, but graphene could make the whole process much more efficient. The main technique used for a large-scale desalinization is called reverse osmosis. As we could recall in our science classes, osmosis pertains to the movement of water from the less salty region to the more salty region. Reverse osmosis, however, deals with the movement of water to the region with little to no salt, therefore creating clean water. This process is costly, however, and expenses a lot of energy. Computer models have predicted that using graphene oxide sheets as sieves to aid desalinization may reduce energy input by about 16 to 46%. It does so by, well, being a sieve. Graphene oxide is porous, and by controlling the pore size, it may filter out salt ions on its own and let water molecules pass through. This requires minimal energy input. As the process is sped up, costs in water treatment will also be effectively reduced, making potable water more accessible in poorer, drier countries. Future developments are still in the works as researchers have been limited inside their laboratories. But who knows? Maybe someday this will be the breakthrough of the century, making potable water accessible to everyone. And for someone who's thirsty, yet stuck in an island surrounded with salinated water, the graphene oxide sieve may be integrated to a, let's say, a straw, bringing you clean water everywhere you go.